Today we read Joel chapter 3. The whole chapter, you can see in those days, the time of return from exile, about the future. First 1 to 11. And then, first 12, and onwards about Jesus coming back the second time. What would happen? Two stages of in those days. First stage, the time of return from exile, what will happen? First one, in those days and at that time, when I restore the fortunes of Judah and Jerusalem. In his vision, God sees that there will be a time. No nation has ever experienced being scattered to the nations and never be returned. And actually, it's a miracle that a country can be gathered back, just like today. History has passed the Han Dynasty or the Song Dynasty. Today, people of descendants of the Song Dynasty would not say, okay, let's gather back at Xi'an and the capital, and then we will restore our Song Dynasty. Or we know that there were the Qing Dynasty, with the descendants of the Qing Dynasty gathered together and say, let's go back to restore our Qing Dynasty. No, that's it's unheard of and also very uncommon. And actually, Israel was scattered to many places, many countries. And after 1,000 years, or after 100 years, they get it back and be restored to a nation. So it's not actually a common, easy thing. It was a miracle that happened. So for the people back then, maybe hard to imagine or believe when they were in exile. But it's true. The Israelites started to gather back after 70 years of exile, and then God gathered them back from all nations. And then God said, I will bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. Verse 2, there I will enter into judgment against them concerning my inheritance, my people Israel, for they scattered my people among the nations and divided up my land. They cast lots for my people and traded boys for prostitutes. They sold girls for wine that they might drink. God wants to gather back the nations. It means God is the judge. God said, I will do something greater to gather the people, the nations, to the valley of judgment. Jehoshaphat means judgment. Why would God judge them? Because of that evil acts. What did they, what had they done? They scattered God's people among the nations, divided up his land, cast lots for his people, traded boys for prostitutes, sold girls for wine. Actually, God wanted to use the nations to discipline Israel, but they treated Israel even harsher than God wanted. They took the land and they sold the boys and made people into prostitutes. That was not God's will. They treated the Israelites worse than what God wanted. They did not fear God. The nations did not fear God. God used them to discipline Israel. But they robbed. It was like they robbed the people of God while they had a fire. They took the opportunity to benefit themselves even more in a really wicked way. So God was going to do two things. God will restore his people and let them be gathered back from exile. And secondly, God will gather the nations to be judged in the valley of Jehoshaphat. Verse 4, now what have you against me, O Tyre and Sidon, and all you regions of Philistia? Are you paying me for something I've done? If you are paying me back, I will swiftly and speedily return on your own hands what you have done. For you took my silver and my gold and carried off my finest treasures to your temples. You sold the people of Judah and Jerusalem to the Greeks that you may send them far from their homeland. See, I'm going to rouse them out of the places to which you sold them, and I will return on your own hands what you have done. I will sell your sons and daughters to the people of Judah, and they will sell them to the Sabians, a nation far away the Lord has spoken. So God said, are you going to repay me, revenge me? And God said, I will repay you. You see that God has chosen Israel. Israel is the apple of God's eye. So if you treat Israel harshly, that means you're treating God harshly. And God says, when I restore the fortunes of Judah and Jerusalem, in the original language, there's a word that's missing in the Chinese translation or NIV, which is behold, look, in those days, at that time, Israel's been through disasters and exile, thrown away between nations. We may also have difficulties in life that the enemy may come into our lives and take away things from us. But God said, in those days and at that time, now I restore the fortunes of Judah and Jerusalem. I will gather all nations and bring them down to the valley. Verse 16, the Lord will be a refuge for his people. The earth and sky will tremble, but the Lord will be a refuge for his people, a stronghold for the people of Israel. Verse 18, in that day the mountains will drip new wine, and the hills will flow with milk. All the ravens of Judah will run with water. Heaven and earth will shake. The fountain will flow out of the Lord's house and will water the valley of Acacias. So those who attack us before, they will come and serve us and provide for us. They'll be like the mountains that drip new wine and the hills that flow with milk. So God will protect us. He'll be our refuge so we can overcome and have be victorious over the enemy. And how would this happen? Is that let God reign in Zion, let God reign in our lives, on the heart of on the throne of our hearts. God sits on our hearts, be enthroned in our heart as we praise Him. So we should let this happen today in the spirit. Let God be our help as we praise Him. Let Him dwell and sit on the throne of our hearts. Let Him be our refuge and our strength so that he can roar from the Zion in our hearts, in the Jerusalem in our heart, the throne in our heart. He will be our refuge and a stronghold. So let's worship the Lord again. Let God's presence come down. Lift up our hands and receive blessing. In Jesus' name, I bless every brother and sister and those online. Lord, give them faith. Open our spiritual eyes so we see that God will roar from Zion. Heaven and earth will shake. God will be you and my refuge. A stronghold for the people of Israel, our strength and our stronghold. In Jesus' name, I put this first into your spirit to become your light and the foundation of your faith and the source of faith, so you can really believe and see that God has risen up from and He's King in Zion, is rolling from Jerusalem. All these strongholds of the enemy will come down. Anyone who attack you will flee in seven ways. God's glory and power surround your people. Lord, your blessings will come. Everything that the enemy tries to steal will be restored in the name of Jesus. Every brother and sister will experience the reality of this scripture, so we can rise up to praise the one who's taking care of us and creating heaven and earth. Thanks for hearing our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord bless you.